Hey guys, it's Pete here, and I just reviewed the recording and the backup recording for the following content. Unfortunately, it is like completely janky in the video. The audio is fine, but the video is not great at all. So the next few videos are not gonna be awesome on the video side of things. You'll definitely be able to see the slides, but my video is a little bit jumpy. The audio is obviously still good. We're not gonna re-record it, but check these out for all of the latest on getting your business and your team connected.
Hey, what's up guys? Pete Moriarty here. Great to be here with you. I'm presenting location independent working with Google Workspace. So in this session, we're going to be talking about location independent working. And what this is all about is building more flexibility in your business and more flexibility in your life. Now, us as a business, IT Genius, we've been around for over 12 years now, and we are really all about helping to liberate small business owners to be more successful, to play a bigger game, and to help you succeed in your business. Now, not only succeed in your business, but hopefully succeed in your life as well, because I really believe that once we have technology on our side, then it can be used as a tool to enrich our life rather than something that we feel like we have to be a slave to. And you know, we've seen all too many business owners who outsource the responsibility and abdicate the responsibility of technology in their business to someone else. And I get it, I understand, you know, if you're not someone who's grown up with technology, you may just find it easier to kind of like make it someone else's problem. But just like the finances in your business or the legals in your business, if you abdicate and leave that to someone else without taking responsibility yourself, sooner or later it's gonna bite you in the bum. Now, with technology, that might mean that you get attacked by a crypto locker virus and you experience data loss in the business. It may mean that you have someone hack into your accounts and steal financial information. It might mean that an employee leaves the business or a contractor leaves the business and mistakenly deletes data on their way out. We see these things happen all the time, unfortunately. And so what our business is all about is about not only assisting businesses as a consultant with their technology, but we also really believe in educating our customers as well. So we primarily work with the Google Workspace ecosystem and the collection of Google's tools and, you know, add-ons and partners for those Google tools as well. But we also try and consult just a little bit in the business realm as well. But like, we're technology consultants, and if we can help you out with your business, then that's ideal. Now, we grew and scaled our business. We've now got over 42, 43 people in the business. I think we've nearly doubled just in the last year. We've been going through a tremendous amount of growth. But as I said, we've been going for 12 years now. So the business has been successful over time. And we've been able to do that in part because of good technology strategy, but with good technology fueling our business strategy. And that's really where we believe the symbiosis of business and technology come together, is when you have a solid business strategy and you shape and use and make use of technology tools around your business strategy. That's what we believe will help businesses to be successful. And we see some pretty common journeys as businesses grow and evolve, from a startup, literally like an idea, to a business that's starting to employ a couple of people, to something that's then in growth mode. Growth mode is where, you know, you're kind of working out the business model and things are growing and scaling as the business is growing up. And then when you get to scale mode, or when you graduate to scale mode, that's really when the business has turned into a real business, we call it. It's then a performance business. And the founder of the business can then kind of like step back, have some more time freedom for themselves. And at that point, then, you know, the business will continue to grow if it's managed and looked after well. But really, the hard yards are done once you get to the scale stage of a business. Now, it's interesting that in Australia, 97.5% or maybe even 98.5% of all businesses actually never make it out of the growth stage. And that's a really sad statistic, because most businesses in that stage are still very resource heavy on the founder. The owner of the business is working the business every day. They're the ones dealing with all the problems, and they're the ones that are, you know, basically the person to call on. When a customer's upset, they're basically, you know, constantly going to the business owner. And so we wanna try and help businesses graduate basically out of that growth mode and get them to scale mode. And when we can get them to scale mode, that means that they've got enough people in the business, and it's literally about the amount of people. They've got enough people in the business, then they can have like a little bit of a management layer. They can have some additional strategic execution that's not all the business owner doing it all. But effectively, they get a lot more of their time freedom back because the business owner is taking hats off and giving those hats to the other team members. Now, does that mean that you quit from the business? No, not necessarily. But what it does mean is that you get to do what you probably got into business for, which is have a bit more freedom. And I'm very thankful myself, you know, thanks to the hard work of myself and also the hard work of my team and our partners and everyone who's been a part of the journey at IT Genius. I'm in that position now. I'm able to travel when I like. I can take time off when I like. The emergencies that come up in the business are mostly handled by our very competent management team. And for me, it allows me to actually step back and have more kind of peak time in my life, which is really awesome. But also aside from that, I'm able to serve the business and serve my team at a higher level and at a more purposeful level because I'm able to help just with the strategy in the business and really bring the magic of my vision as the founder of the business to actually help out with that. So that's really what our aim is at IT Genius. You know, obviously we can't help you with your finances, we can't help you with your marketing, but what we can do is we can help you with the technology strategy. So whatever your business strategy is, we want to help you with the technology strategy, and we want to help graduate you from a launch to a startup or a startup to a growth or wherever you are right now into a scale company. And so you, the founder, can have a much better relationship with your business and hopefully with your life as well. Now, we are in a remote work reality. COVID has hit and it has thrown everyone onto Zoom and onto Google Meet or whatever your preferred video meeting tool of choice is. And I think by now everyone's pretty damn sick of online meetings. And the key problem with everyone switching to remote or online work during COVID is that most people just opened up Zoom and continued to work exactly the same way that they were working. Now, no doubt that people are getting meeting fatigue, people are having all kinds of productivity issues, people are having all kinds of mental health issues as well, all kinds of problems that are starting to pop up now because in my opinion, people are not really using the tools as they're designed to be used, and you know, maybe there's just a lack of competency around how to actually run a business remotely. Now, our business has been completely remote for over 6 years now, and so everyone works at home or they can work from different locations. I personally happen to travel a lot, and that gives us a lot of flexibility in how we work and a lot of flexibility in how we deliver to our customers as well. Previously, when we grew and started the business, we were based just in Sydney and we could only really service customers in Sydney. But as my vision kind of expanded, I thought, well, you know, what would we have to do to position ourselves to service businesses right across Australia? And we ended up setting a remote team. And we were able then to re-engineer our products and services so we can deliver remotely. And not only do we deliver to customers in Australia, but now all around the world, which is pretty darn exciting. And so what I want to share with you, and we go into depth in this inside Genius Academy, and Genius Academy is accessible just for our concierge subscribers. And so if you're interested in getting access to a deeper course on this work, then go and check out our concierge program on our website, itgenius.com. But what I want to share a little bit with you guys is, well, how do you work remotely? Like, how do you actually get productive work done? And I'm going to share a little bit about location independence, because that's certainly a part of it. But also I want to share a little bit about what are the best practices with teams working remotely and what's been successful for us. Now, you know, I haven't written the book on remote work. And to be honest, this, you know, it's pretty new for companies to be completely remote and to not have an office. But what I tend to do is just share kind of what's working for us over many years of trying to run and grow a successful business with a remote team. And hopefully those are useful for you. So before I jump into those tips, I want you to think and reflect for a second and ask yourself a question. If I could work from anywhere in the world, where would I work from? If I could make my office anywhere on Mother Earth, the planet, where would I make my office? And if you're on the live stream, drop that down in the comments now. If you're watching this, I'd love to know in the comments where you would like to work from, if you could work from absolutely anywhere in the world. Let me know. Now, don't give me any excuses about, oh no, my business can't work remotely. I hope that COVID has finally like drilled into everyone's heads that yes, you can actually get working remotely happening. So I used to run this slide on my presentations all the time saying that the future of work was remote. And we've been talking about this for about 5 years now. And then COVID happened and everyone has now literally forced to be remote, which has opened up not only a lot of, you know, new business models and new ways of working, but it has really shown people the reality that businesses can actually work remotely. And companies like IT Genius and like Google have been doing this for many years, not necessarily in the instance of Google working 100% remotely, but at least providing flexible options for your team to work. And that's an important point, is that for me, you know, we're a pretty radical business. We try new things. You know, most of our team are under 30 years old or around about 30 years old. And so we're kind of like a bit of a new age business, you know, very millennial in nature, in that we do things quite differently to the norm. And we don't expect everyone's going to follow us and follow exactly what we do because that may not suit you or what your goals are or what's important to you. But what we do hope is that by being that, you know, radical kind of like vagabonding testers of new ways of working, that we can maybe inspire you to shift the way that you're working by 10 or by 20%. And if we've done that, then we've done our job. And so that's what we try and do. Now, the reality of right now is that everyone is working remotely. However, no one's really been taught how to work remotely. We've been kind of forced to shift from working in an office, you know, for many people, literally commuting to an office every day, to now working at home. And there comes all of the challenges of how to work at home productively. Now, I'm not going to spend too much time on that. I'm just going to share a couple of my top tips. But I want to share more about, you know, how you can lead your business to be a remote company and how that can change your lifestyle as a business owner. Because honestly, there really aren't many resources around how you should be working or how you should be doing things. And it's funny, I think there's like probably a little bit of shame around being a business owner who's not there and in the business, right? If you think about, you know, well, if you have a customer and that customer has the perception that you're living in a caravan and driving around the place whenever you feel like it, as I do from time to time, then a little bit of kind of stuff sometimes comes up for us where that little voice in the back of our head says, you should be working harder, or that's not a real business. And so I think the number one thing for you to do before you embark on trying to actually practically change how your business works is first check in on your mindset. You know, are you actually ready to work remotely? Are you ready to give yourself permission to work differently? I know that at least in my business, it required some really big shifts in the business in terms of our business model and how we were going to actually, you know, change what we were delivering to customers. And it was only when I first got my mindset ready that I give Peter permission to have this life, and I give Peter permission to do things this way. And I know that I won't get it perfect. And I know that, you know, one customer might hit me up on, you know, about something on Facebook, and I might be at the beach for the day and have my phone switched off. I gave myself permission to fail. But first, because I had my mindset in check, then I was able to then make the changes that I needed to make in the business. Thank you.